A lot of people here, y'all gotta keep moving, right? Yeah, my name's Ed Henry, I'm from Hartsville, Alabama. Never been in politics before at all until I made the mistake of complaining to God one night about why we don't have better people in government. He hit me with the fact that they don't make themselves available. And if you really care, make yourself available. Slapped me around, I fought him for months, and he ended up winning as usual, and lo and behold, here I am. Didn't know much about it other than just shoot straight, tell it like it is, and go through life with no regrets, basically. When I look around at what we've got in politics these days, we've got a system that is set up so that you basically do your time. We hear this all the time in Montgomery, Will and I do. Well, you can't be this because you haven't been here long enough. You can't be the governor because you haven't been in politics. You can't be the chairman or the speaker or whatever it is because you haven't been here long enough. But if you'll just sit tight, mind your business, mind your tongue, you'll get your opportunity. But what happens is the more you sit and you don't do anything and you listen and you're quiet, you forget how to be a regular person like the rest of us. And you become this political entity, this almost class of people that live in our capital cities and in our nation's capital because they come up through this pipeline of politics. Where to get anywhere, you have to sit on your hands, bide your time, wait for your opportunity. And I'm going to throw some kudos to Rubio. One of the things he gets beat up on is he didn't wait in line. But the problem I have with him is he's in the freaking line. I want somebody that's outside, that from all perspectives is truly taking a step down from his personal position to become the president of the United States. Everybody else in the race on either side of the aisle, Republican or Democrat, is aspiring to be the president of the United States. They've done everything in their lives so that when it's put on a postcard, it looks beautiful. It looks great, it looks grand, and it'll trick anybody in any category into going that direction. Donald Trump's the opposite of that. He is the anti-politician. And I'm telling you, the reason that it resonates with people in the United States, it's not because he's an eloquent speaker, but he says what he's thinking. And that's refreshing. It's refreshing to me. It's refreshing to the majority of people that listen to what's going on. And so when I look at him, he doesn't necessarily have the same relationship with Christ that I do? He doesn't. Because my relationship with Jesus Christ is personal. But I don't necessarily need him to have my relationship. I need him to have a relationship. And he does. He says he does. And that's all I can take him on. But I know that God can use anybody, anywhere, anytime, for his purpose and his will. And I believe in today's world, if we don't turn it around, this is our opportunity. This is our line in the sand. If we don't go away from the political class that's been set up for two centuries, we're probably going to lose our opportunity. Barack Obama set out with an intent to destroy America, and he's done a damn good job of it. If we don't look to somebody that's outside the box, that's willing to tell him, he doesn't care if it's politically correct or not, we don't look for somebody like Donald Trump, we're going to end up with more of the same. We're going to sit here for 4 years and we're going to be told, well, it takes time to reverse all of these things. It takes time. We just got to give us a little bit more time, and we will take care of it. But I think we're out of time. And when I look at the landscape out there, the different individuals that are running, look, I'll take all of them. I'll take every single person on the Republican ticket over a Hillary Clinton or a Bernie Sanders. There's no doubt. But I do believe that Donald Trump is the only true outsider that can change the face of our nation and bring America back to its greatness. See, we were founded by individuals. And who says the House and the Senate don't get along? We were founded by men who were successful in their personal lives and then made a sacrifice to come and give a public service to this country, to develop this country and to found it. We've lost that. Today, there's a mantra that if you want to be anything in politics, you've got to spend that time. You've got to be in that line. And that's what's refreshing to me about Donald Trump. I'll tell you a quick little story and I'll let you go. I went to the wrong locals because I wasn't paying attention to what my GPS was saying. I was talking on the phone and I saw Logan's. Well, that must be it. So I pulled in, got out, had an armful of t-shirts and bumper stickers. I go in, I go to the little lady standing out front. I said, Republican Party? And they looked at me like I had three heads. And I said, wrong Logan's. And she said, yes, you probably want the one in Florence. And she started telling me where it was. I said, oh, thank you very much. Would you like a t-shirt? And I give her a t-shirt, and it became a feeding frenzy of people in Logan's wanting a Trump t-shirt. I promise you, I've never seen anything like this in my entire life, where regular, everyday individuals are excited about an opportunity to take back our country. And that's what we're looking at. I want a leader, I want a president that's more like John Wayne than Justin Bieber.